We've all borne witness to the chaos that has been happening in parts of the country in the past few days. And one of the people who fell victim, or one of the business people who fell victim to this, was former Orlando Pirates captain Lucky Lekgwathi, who now joins me via our video line. Lucky, good morning, and thank you so much for your time this morning under the difficult circumstances. And I know you had your fast food joint out in Kliptown in Soweto called Grootman. I firstly want to say to you, I'm very sorry at what happened. I spoke to you after the happening itself. But how did you find out, first of all? How did you rock up there to find that the place was destroyed? Did you get a phone call? What happened?
Yeah, good morning to all the viewers at home. I got a first call, in the morning around, I think, 10 o'clock, and they were telling me that they are looting in Kliptown, and I asked them if our place is safe, and they said, no, it's safe, and we asked our employees that to close the shop. They closed the shop, then they remained there until, I think until 12 o'clock, and they said, no, they are busy at our shopping center. Because of the shopping center, it was how many? 4 shops. And later they said, no, they open one of the shops, and it's next to my shop, and they went to another shop again, which is you safe, and they went to the third shop, and surprisingly, my shop is the first shop next to the gate. And the later I got a call again. They said, no, they are busy, with Grootman. And how it started, The two guys, they just kicked the door, and they started hitting the door. Only two guys. I said, it's because of majority. People, they can't love you, all of them. Some don't love you. Some they'll have jealousy, some don't hate you. And they said those two guys, that the ones that they opened the shop, because of others, they were not near to the shop. But after they opened, obvious, some even they got tempted and, went inside the shop. And which is sad.
Yeah.
Because of,
Lucky, I just want to find out, sorry to come in there. The shop just opened just a few months ago in April, if I'm not mistaken. How much work was put into that for you personally? How much did it take from you to finally get it up and running? We always encourage footballers to try and find some sort of income outside of the game.
Yeah, obvious. Especially you're saying the truth. Because of it's all about leading by an example, so that other players, they can follow you. It took us, 3 to 4 months, to make that shop. But for them, it's only to them, 30 seconds to destroy the shop. Yeah, and, we put a lot of hard work, traveling to Kliptown every day, making calls, finding, people. When you make a shop, you need, too many people, plumbers, electricians, and obvious, to buy the equipment. And they took all the equipment, everything that was in the shop, they took it, And they stole it, because of it was stealing, not, to And yeah, they took everything, and the hard work that we put there, it was said, it is said because of it took us, 4 to 5 months to make that shop, but for them it only took them 30 seconds. Yeah.
Lucky, do you know what the estimate of the damage is? How much it's going to cost you to get back up on your feet, and how do you plan to get back on your feet and make it and get it up and running again?
Yeah, it's not going to be easy, it's going to be tough, but the estimation plus minus 400,000. But because of the support of the people, especially from social media, it's so powerful. I didn't know, because of when I was a soccer player, I was not on social media, but now, because of the ambassador, That's why I'm on social media, and it's helping me a lot. You know, even people, they ask me to create account number so that they can contribute, you know. And I was talking to one of the top politicians. He said even him is going to contribute. And yeah, which is, you know, the support of the people, it's always unbelievable, you know. And amazing to know that people, they love you. And they say when days are dark, friends are few. But for me, you know, yeah, days are dark for me, but friends are many, you know, calls that I'm getting, you know, my WhatsApp. Yesterday I had 400 WhatsApp, you know, and my Instagram and my Facebook account, it's booming. I can't even answer, you know, some of them.
Yeah.
And thank you so very much for their support. It shows that, you know what, they still support and they still love Lucky Lekgwathi.
Can the fans help you out, Lucky, in 20 seconds?
Bruh, you know, I think, and that's why I'm saying thanks to them. Like today, I posted my foundation account number, and people, you know, the messages are so amazing and unbelievable, you know. They are saying they are going to pump money so that I can rebuild my store again, because of it's not my store, it's, you know, their reassurance, you know. Growth money is not like it's not all about like Lekgwathi.
Yeah. Lucky, you are a sportsman. You know all about great comebacks, and I suspect you're going to have to find that inside you at this moment to come back. That spirit of the double treble back in the 2011-2012 season will have to come out again. That's where we leave it at this hour. Lucky Lekgwathi's fast food joint also destroyed in the looting.